friends, I am Dr. Awdhesh Singh and I welcome you to Awdhesh Academy. Friends, we see many people in this world. Some people are good, some people are bad, some people are successful, some people are unsuccessful. Now, what makes one person different than the other person? The most important thing between a good person and a bad person, successful person and unsuccessful person, is the habit which they have. We are the product of our habit. If our habits are good, we achieve great success in life. If our habits are bad, we fail to achieve anything in life. If you are in the habit of laziness, postponement, or you are in the habit of addiction, drinking, you cannot succeed. At the same time, if you have good habits, for example, walking, exercising, working, learning, then you are likely to succeed in life. Now, habit is something which makes our job very easy. We get up in the morning and there are so many things we do as a matter of habit, whether it is brushing your teeth or walking or taking breakfast, going to the office, studying. So if something becomes part of our habit, then it becomes almost like an automatic thing. We don't have to put any effort. But for somebody else who is not into that habit, it is an effortful process. So somebody who is in the habit of, for example, morning walk will naturally get ready and go for a walk. But somebody who is not in the habit of getting into morning walk, he has to actually persuade himself, he has to motivate himself, and he has to put a lot of effort in doing the same thing. So one great secret of success is to develop good habits and to get rid of the bad habits. Now, how to do it and what is the importance of habit? This is the lesson for today. So first of all, in order to explain the importance of habit, let me quote from Aristotle. Now, Aristotle has said, excellence is an art won by training and habituation. We do not act rightly because we have virtues or excellence, but we rather have those because we have acted rightly. We are what we repeatedly do. Excellence then is not an act but an habit. So this is a very important thing we have to understand. The people who are producing excellence are the people who are in the habit of producing excellence. If we are doing right things every day, every moment, every month, then we are becoming a right person. And a person who is doing a wrong thing, he becomes a wrong person. And therefore, the difference is that we have to get rid of the bad habits and we have to cultivate a good habit. Now, in order to understand how we can create a good habit and get rid of the bad habit, let us see this picture. Here you see that there is a grass field on which there is a path. Now, in this path, there was once a grass on that path also. But people started traveling on that path, and gradually what happened that the grass got trampled and it got dead gradually. And now the path is created and now everybody is following that path. And because everybody is traveling on that path, the fresh and new grass cannot grow. Now this is like your habit. In the habit, if you are doing everything in a systematic way, we are doing the same thing every day, then it becomes part of habit. And then it is very difficult to get rid of because it becomes automatic thing and we just do without any effort. So if you want to get rid of that habit, you just cannot get rid of that habit because it is so easy to do the same thing. The only way to get rid of this habit is to create a new habit. Now, how to create a new habit? If you see the same example, like the grass field, then in the grass field, if you want to achieve to some other goal, then you have to create a new path. And if you create a new path, initially it will be difficult because there will be a lot of grass on that. And when you will trample the grass, you have to be very careful in following that path. But gradually what will happen when you keep following that path day after day, then naturally a path will be created. And then after what will happen that the old path will automatically die down and a green grass will come and then you will have no difficulty in following the new path. In the same way, once we keep on following a good habit, then the bad habit will automatically be forgotten. Now, many people say that I will get rid of the habit of smoking, I will get rid of the habits of laziness or anything else. But they can't, because in order to get rid of the old habit, you have to create a new habit. So you have to see how you are going to substitute that old habit. If you want to substitute an old habit of drinking, for example, then maybe you have to create a new habit of, reading, or maybe a new habit of walking, or a new habit of listening song. So if you cultivate a new good habit, then you will be able to get rid of the old habit. So this is the clue, and this is the method how we can succeed in cultivating a new habit and get rid of the old habit. So if you want to get rid of the old habit, think what you want to do, where you want to arrive, and then create a new path for yourself. And once you create a new path and start traveling on that, you will automatically get rid of the bad habit. So I hope that you have understood from today's lecture that the only way to get rid of the old habit is to create a new habit and not do the bad thing at all, or not to follow the old habits at all. Just resist the temptation of following the easiest path and travel on the new path. And if you follow it only for 3 to 4 weeks, then you will find that a new habit has developed, and thereafter you will not even think about the old habit. Thank you very much for watching my video, and please share your views and comments, and I'll be very happy to give any new lectures or on any new topic. Thank you very much.